have those when you're reviewing those. Avoid foods, starches, pretty much any grain that's not the three that we allow in the product. So wheat, barley, any of those types of things. Long list, too much to go into detail here, but they're all on there. And then any of those foods made with those products, pasta, your general noodles, breads, grains, cereals, anything like that you want to stay away from as well. Okay? You may possibly be able to find some pasta that's made with 100% quinoa, but again, look at the ingredients, because a lot of times if they may be mixed grains. But if you can find one that's 100% quinoa and it happens to be a pasta, go for it if you really want the pasta. Okay? Sugars and sweeteners, like we said, you're avoiding them all. We get a question often on stevia. Stevia is more of an herb, okay? It's not actually a sugar, it's an herb. Again, I caution you to look at the ingredients. I tried to find some stevia that didn't have added sugar or added other sweeteners, but pretty much everything I found did. So if you can find one that's just straight up stevia and use it like a spice, that's fine if you want to sweeten that one. Okay? Fruits. The big thing to avoid are going to be those dried fruits that also have the added sugars, and also fruit juices. Okay? The only juices allowed on the challenge are going to be your lemon and lime juice. And it's not the limeade, which is both the lime sugar. It's a squeezed lemon or a squeezed lime. That's what we buy the lemon or lime juice. Okay. Vegetables, pretty much if it's a starchy vegetable, except for the ones on the allowed list, the sweet potatoes, the parsnips, and the taro, you don't want to do those. Another starchy vegetable that we're not allowing for this challenge is corn. Okay? Corn, yes, it has fiber. Yes, technically it's a legume, but it really doesn't have a lot of nutrition value aside from that. And it's in a lot of the products that people tend to overeat, particularly like corn oil and things like that. So we're trying to stay away from that one for this challenge. So peas, yes. Corn, no. Okay? Proteins, the fatty meats, so pretty much we want to stay away from the fatty meats and those processed meats that have the nitrates. So, you know, if you want to do lunch meat sandwiches, that's fine. Just pay attention to if there's any preservatives or nitrates added to those meats. And I have some information, at least from Borsa, that they sent me, so I can post a list of their foods that don't have any preservatives. So if you want that information, we'll make sure you get that. Soy. We do allow the edamame, we do allow tempeh and the what? No, we don't allow tofu. Basically, the soy products that are allowed are going to be your whole soy products that come from the bean. So tofu, they strip all the fiber out of the bean. Tempeh, they make it with the bean. So you can have the tempeh, it's more meaty, more hearty. Soy nuts, soy milk, particularly soy oil, that's a hard one to stay away from. Those are not allowed on the challenge. Okay? Fats, the list is right here, but the corn oil, the soy oil, a lot of the vegetable oils that aren't on the allowed food list, those are the ones that you want to stay away from. Okay? So that's the basic allows and not allows. Other food rules, I'm going to look at the list just to make sure I don't forget one for you guys. But you basically want to make sure that you're not eating more than 500 calories a meal. You want to make sure you're not going more than 5 hours apart between meals or snacks. What are some of the other ones? You don't want to eat out. I will spend some time talking a little bit more about that. You want to try and get 2 servings of fruit a day and 5 servings of vegetables a day. That's kind of the numbers we came up with for some fruit, but more vegetables. So 2 fruits, 5 servings.